Now we move to Roberto Giuffada from Italy. Italians are famous for many things, but fast cars is indeed one of them. So we look forward to the case studies regarding the automotive industry. Roberto, the floor is yours.
Okay. Good afternoon to everybody. I thank you.
To change the presentation.
Okay.
This is yours?
Yes. No? Yes.
There you are. Good. You can use this one or the...
Okay. Again. Good afternoon to everybody. I am very, very happy to be here, and thanks to have invited me in this occasion. What I want to show you is the Maserati case. Maserati is a well-known automotive maker, Italian automotive maker. It's a part of FCA, Fiat Chrysler Automobile. Is the fashion the brand with most fashion in FCA, if we don't consider Ferrari, of course, but Ferrari is something different. It's like a dream. It's not exactly automotive, I think, and this is an automotive, something more acceptable. I start showing you a very short movie.
With the Ghibli, we wanted to produce a new Maserati, meaning that the Ghibli adheres to the core brand values of Maserati, being Italian style, dynamic performance, and refined luxury. The challenge, obviously, in terms of launching higher volume cars within a modern manufacturing facility, state-of-the-art manufacturing facility, is to retain that bespoke feeling within the cars, which is very much appreciated by our clients.
Being able to work in a digital twin is a significant evolution compared with the past. By using integrated software such as NX and TeamCenter, we can have an interface of all the teams developing the project on the same mathematical base. This allows us to reduce analysis times and to avoid possible errors caused by miscommunication between the different teams.
We can say that one of the strong points of Siemens is the fact that we offer a product portfolio which covers both the manufacturing and the engineering side. And what's more, that these products are also tightly integrated.
The Technomatics tools are above all useful in the analysis of the product and in the simulation of the product line. Earlier planning and development know-how is thereby incorporated and implemented in the overall design. The aim was to produce three times as many cars than before, while maintaining the same level of quality, which is obviously higher simply because it is a Maserati.
Well, CAS is an integrated system used by the entire Fiat Chrysler Automobiles group and is also installed in the Maserati plant. It facilitates the management of the plant with Siemens PLC and HMI hardware with WinCC and Step 7, delivering all the diagnostics of everything that happens in the plant in real time.
Di tutto quello che succede sull'impianto.
So Siemens technology helps us to be more efficient and have better quality management in the production plant.
The expertise is not only in the tool, so not only in the software, but above all, about how to use the software within the setting of Maserati and FCA, because that is where we really make the difference.
Okay, this is from Maserati, and Maserati, as you can imagine, is all the most advanced technology in terms of digitalization, the process, the digitalization of the product, and the plant is inside such kind of customer, used and up and running. But I try to tell you something of the reason, the general reason because this approach is useful in general is start not from technology point of view, because you need to have the last technology, IoT technology or something like this also, but this is not the main reason. Because what you see on the screen is a general process that you can, very general, you start from a product definition, then you have a process planning, technology definition, and the production engineering, and then the production, so the start of production. This is a washing machine, but any kind, even the automotive, works in this way, and then the service. This is, let me say, no more sufficient, sorry. No more sufficient, because in the last year, manufacturing company to survive in increasing competitive market are forced to reduce continuously the time to market. So you have to produce a new innovative component, complex component, or product faster than before every time. You have to think about the smartphone, for instance. Every 6 months, no more than 6 months, we have a new smartphone. Produce more complex object complex in terms of also technology, built-in technology, small quantities and ever increasing quality. And also make the production more flexible, because the requirement from the market is unpredictable. The production plan is more difficult than in the past, and you have a window of a time very short in which you have to react to the request of the market. Even you have, if you do something, you have to include the customer in very early stage of the product design feasibility. It's a complex situation. What you have to do to react to this situation, to fight in this situation? Mainly, of course, this is a simplification, only to give you an idea about what could be two main actions that must be done. One is adopt a very innovative technology, ICT technology, enabling integration and collaboration along the whole value chain, because we have to consider not sector by sector, but the entire value chain, and modify dramatically the manufacturing processes. So, new technology, but also a process able to accept the new technology in order to use them in a correct way. The added value is not the technology, but the usage of the technology inside, the experience you are able to do for using the new technology, because after 2 years, 3 years, you have to change this technology, but experience remain in any case. If you wait to do this, generally, of course, generally speaking, the problem increase, and the gap between you and the competitor could be very, very high. So the topics are speed. You must be faster than before. Faster means change something, produce something faster. You must be flexible and increasing the quality as much as possible and efficiency. Changing, adopting new technologies, but also changing something in terms of processes inside your company. Adopting new technologies, but taking care that also the security is absolutely important. Because the security is important, the cyber crimes exist inside the industry, outside the industry, with our smartphone and so on. So you have to take in consideration that if you adopt a huge technology, a connected technology inside your industry, you have to increase your security. Maserati. Generally speaking, the challenges from the automotive industry is the reducing time to market, as I told, enhancing the flexibility, increase the efficiency. Shorter innovation cycle, more complex product, larger data volume. I don't know if you are familiar with the number, the figure in the automotive. An average line, production line in the automotive is able to produce around 800 vehicles per day. Every minute in your workstation, it's passing through a specific vehicle, and you are not able to produce more than 2-3 equal vehicle per year. Okay, so every vehicle passing through, I am the worker, through my workplace, needs something specific for that vehicle. And this is important. You try to imagine, I give you very often I do this kind of example, the operation to mount a bumper. The bumper is a very common object, but in 1 minute I have to detect that this is a yellow car, and this yellow car, exactly this yellow car and not the previous on the other car, needs to have a specific bumper with a specific sensor, yes or not, or some other specific object for that vehicle in 1 minute. So I have to find exactly the yellow bumper correct just beside me. I cannot call at that moment the bumper. All the material are just in time. The engine is just in time, the wheel is just in time, any kind of object inside the car is called in just-in-time mechanism. So the organization is absolutely a big organization necessary to take in consideration this situation in a very short time. I have to change something. If I have to detect some not conformancy, I have to be flexible, because every, let me say, 2 or 3 days, something is changed on the line. I have to take in consideration this, and it costs a lot. And also in terms of efficiency, in terms of energy and resources. The solution from Maserati point of view is to integrate as much as possible the product and process definition, the engineering of the plant, and also the production. It's not normal to have such kind of integration, because all the worker and the departments have to work in parallel somehow in order to do the right things, considering what I told before, the complexity And this is not easy, so you must be helped from the IT technology that in this case, and we are happy about this, is Siemens technology. Product definition, process definition, and production. I try to explain a little bit, this is a little bit technical, because I don't know if who of you is familiar with this, but the first silos, generally speaking, is the product design. So it's a huge number of people able and focused on the product definition, and focused on the product documentation, and the reference for them is the bill of material, and all is necessary to define the product with the product definition point of view. In this case, they use a product that is called PLM, Product Lifecycle Management, in which there is inside some authoring tool that are CAD or 3D graphic authoring tool able to define the product and test the product. The second silos is the process definition. Process means transform the product in operation and specifications to realize the plant and the line in a correct way, according to the product in terms of cost, in terms of it's specific work with specific tools, software tool, high performance tool, able to define the process. And then at the end you have the plant. The plant is controlled by different layers of software in order to take in account the workplace, the line, the specific department, and so on. This tree, this is again a very, very big simplification, of course, but this is the situation. And usually they work in separated way. They are integrated inside the silos, but separated department, separated with the other department. What we have done with Maserati is to integrate all the product and process definition in only one platform, able to take in account the integration, the collaboration environment, but considering the specific work must be done silos by silos in any way. This is what we call a holistic vision. But this is the ICT point of view, the tool point of view. What makes the difference is the processes, are the processes. The processes must be adequated to use those technologies. And this is what Maserati did. But let me say, at the end of the product and process definition, what you see just on the left is something that doesn't exist, it's something virtual. You don't have any piece of any component, any engine, any wheel, any nothing, only virtual. The number of the prototype in Maserati is zero. They produce at the beginning, the first production is useful to test directly the car that are not prototype, but are the early production of the line, to tune the line. This is because they have such kind of system, but also they went ahead considering also the production. Imagine that you have defined with the supplier exactly the plant and the line necessary to produce what is engineered in terms of product and process. You have the system able to produce, but there is no real communication between the virtual situation on the left, the PLM area, and the plant, in which, in the reality, you are able to produce the car because you correct something. During the production, you consider that you have to correct some error or something like this, and you do something. So we have realized for them a specific environment able to put in together, to close the loop. So, virtual definition of the product and the process, and then the control, the complete control of the manufacturing area, the production area, able to feed, to send back the information of the reality, able to correct the virtual twin, the virtual representation of the product and the process. Okay? This is, of course, is a simplification, but more or less give you an idea about the work has been done in Maserati. So they have this is done for Ghibli, for Maserati Levante, and for Alfa Romeo, but all over in the FCA production Europe, at least Europe, but also in Chrysler. They have the production engineering, the process engineering, and they have realized this, let me say, balance between the digital representation and the reality of the factory. All the operation inside the plant are testing in virtual months and months before the start of production. This is, let me say, absolutely innovative situation that allow to Maserati to hit very, very great result, to reduce the 30%, as you saw in the video, 30% of the time to market, and to hit a very fantastic target in the production. I show you very fast what is the situation, the normal situation that you have in such kind of production line. What you can see on the right is called operator terminal. Every six meters, there is one or two operator terminal in the line. You have to consider that through this operation terminal, you have to see something necessary to do your work that is 1 minute work. Okay? So you must have time to see and to react very fast in order to do something according to what is shown in the operator terminal. And this is tuned and connected with the organization, because you have the non-conformances, material that is not correct. So you have to tell to the system that this is not conformance. You have to do a huge amount of operation to do when something is wrong. Okay, all this situation is under control of the system and tuned with the product and process virtual definition, as I've shown before. So the brain of production is production, order management, operation result collection, quality check, feedback, tools, devices management, vehicle tracking along the line, undone management. The undone is the specific terminal able to show what is happening on the line, not in a specific workplace. There are a huge number of operator terminals, huge. The problem is not the number of the terminals, but the information that you have to prepare every day in order to make it possible and to work on this operator terminal. And a lot of portable devices you can see on the screen that are absolutely tuned with this vision. Let me say something in terms of benefit. Changes and issues managed in virtual environment at very early stage are the driver is 3D plant layout design, robotic and assembly simulation, ergonomic simulation, logistic and material flow simulation. You have to consider that when you start produce a vehicle, the first, more or less, the first six during the first 6 months, you change more than 100% of the delivered components, more than 100% in 6 months. This is not you because you've grown something, because the evolution and the startup of the production. This is for Maserati, this is for BMW, so this is the normal way to work in automotive. Okay, so you have to imagine the organization behind such to take under control the situation, and they have process and tool standardization in terms standard of the shelf processing step catalog, reusable process in a global production process scenario, and also the line builder, because. Is not Maserati able to build the plant? They need to have the builder able, the line builder able to produce the builder according to the specification from Maserati. All this situation require integration, collaboration. Inside Maserati and outside, in terms of the supplier and line builder. This is more or less the presentation of the case. I have something to tell you or to explain you in terms of Industry 4.0, but in the next slot I will be more detailed about this. Thank you. Questions? Okay, thank you.